Hello children, hope you all are doing well and safe at home, and hope all have watched the videos which I am sending you regularly every week. So today's discussion topic will be the keyboard and the mouse. In the previous classes I have explained to you about the smart machine, okay? Then I have explained to you the parts of computers, okay? Then in the previous video I had discussed about the places where computers are used and for what purpose, and two devices of a computer, which was monitor and the CPU. So today's discussion topic will be keyboard and next one will be the mouse. So these are the four important parts of a computer. When all these four come together, it is a perfect smart machine, okay? So first let us begin with the what is a keyboard. A keyboard is connected to the CPU. It will be, all the devices will be connected to the CPU only. The same manner, even the keyboard is also connected to the CPU. Now children, when teachers give you some notes, what do? You take a book, you take a pencil and you start writing. So along with that, you will try to keep some study materials, which are scale, eraser and sharpener, all these things you will be using. So now you take a pencil and you start writing in your book. Now if you have to do that in your computer, you wanted to type something in the computer, what do? Will you write with a pencil? No. What you have to use? You have to use a keyboard, because keyboard is the device which allows and helps you to type some alphabets, numbers, some symbols, etc., etc. So now we are going to see what is the keyboard. Keyboard is an input device. Why do you call it as an input device? Because we input the data into the computer. We try to put the information into the computer. So it is called as the input device. And what is there on the keyboard? There are different types of buttons. So these buttons are called as keys. And the keyboard is divided into different types, children. There are different parts of the computer. In that different parts, the keys are divided into a different categories. So now we are going to see what is a keyboard, how many keys are there on a keyboard, what are the important keys which you are going to use when you type into the computer. So the first one is keyboard. You can see, children, this is called as the keyboard, and in this there are different keys or varieties of keys. Out of that we are going to see some important keys. So these buttons are called as keys, and they are 108 to 112 keys on the keyboard, and these different keys allows you to do one or the other work in your work. Whenever you sit and operate in front of the computer, these are the different keys which allows you to type and feed the data into the computer. So these are the three important keys which you are going to use whenever you start typing. Now for example, when you are writing with a pencil and a book, what you do? You try to start writing. There will be some mistakes and all these things are very common, quite common. So now you start writing, children. You have ended the line of the first line. You wanted to come to the next line. What do? You take your hand down and you start writing the next line. Again you come down, you start writing the third line. In the computer, when you start typing something, you have to come to the next line. You just can't type and go continuously. Instead, you have to come to the next line. When you have to come to the next line, what you have to do? You have to use the enter key. So enter key will help you to come to the next line or to start the next line. Next one is the space bar. You start typing and just continuously you will be typing. There is no, they have asked you to type one paragraph. You are simply typing and going. You have not done any spacing work at all. So what happens? The person who is reading your text, the person who is reading the paragraph, what they feel? They are not understanding anything. Why? Because you have not given any space between any letter, any words, or between any sentences. So for that reason, what you have to do is, you have to take the space bar. If you take the space bar, you click on the space bar, what happens? It will give you the space between one word, two words, or maybe between the sentences. So the space bar is used to give the space and backspace. All of you have seen an eraser, children. For what purpose eraser is used? Eraser is used to erase the wrongly written words. So what you do whenever you write something, some spelling mistakes are there, you immediately take a eraser and you rub it out. In the same manner, on the keyboard, when you type something with the keyboard, something went wrong, what helps you? And backspace key helps you to erase the wrong character which is typed in the monitor, children. Okay? So, this is the keyboard. The buttons on the keyboard are called as keys. There are 108 to 112 keys on the keyboard. And the important keys which are used to while typing are enter key, which allows you to start a next line, and space bar, which allows you to give a space between two words, and backspace erases the wrong letters. And next one, what we are going to see is mouse. All of you have seen a mouse. Most of you might have seen a mouse. So what does the mouse has? It has a wire which connects to the CPU. On the mouse, there are two buttons with one scroll button. So what is the work of a mouse? The mouse is also an input device. It is an input device. Why? Because we click on something and that is displayed on the monitor. So which all allows you to give the data, no? Those all devices are called as input devices. Okay? So the mouse is called as the pointing device. Why it is called as the pointing device? It is called as the pointing device because we point some icons, we click on the icons, we select the icons, we double click the icons, we drag the icons. Okay? So only the mouse is called as the pointing device, and the mouse is having two buttons, which is right click, which is and a left click, and in between there is a button which is called as the scroll button. Okay, children? So these are the two parts of a computer, and they both are input devices which allows you to feed the data into the computer. So you all hope you all have understood this discussion topic, children. With the next topic, we will see you in the next class. Watch the video, and if you have not understood, repeatedly watch and finish up all your assignments. Stay home, stay safe, children. See you in the next session. Bye, children.